Hello. I'll begin by quoting the first verse of a poem. This is the midnight, let no star delude us, dawn is very far. This is the tempest long foretold, slow to make head but sure to hold. Fairly appropriate for a formerly nautical town, but it's the first verse of Kipling's The Storm Cone, which was probably his last great poem, which was amazingly published on the 23rd of May 1932. And the Daily Telegraph, I've never previously heard of the poem, but the Daily Telegraph headed their editorial with it on the 11th of September, sorry, the 12th of September 2001. So I thought it was appropriate to read it here. We do live in a truly mind-boggling world where most people, formerly poverty-stricken people, many millions of them, are gradually getting a better standard of living, although some of them are having to put up with appallingly filthy air to enjoy their standard of living. But there are some people who are so angry that they not only want to kill themselves, they want to kill eight-year-old girls. So we've got serious problems. I know the Prime Minister has got a lot of experience with security, and quite honestly, I'd rather she was Prime Minister than Jeremy Corbyn. But it's a bit like the Warner's Hotels ad. You know, I don't want. I like kids, but I don't want them here. I prefer to be the MP than Sir Hugo Squire.
1 minute to go now.
Right. Okay. I'm particularly interested in the health service, which is obviously in serious trouble. Particularly the mental health arm of the health service. Education, which the community college in Exmouth is an outstanding school, and it's amazing how well it's run considering how huge it is. But Jill Elson, I think, is a brilliant chair of the governance, and Ray Davison, who's somebody I know quite well. And has issued an astonishing excuse for his candidate not being here.
Mike, yes, your 3 minutes.
Right, okay.
You'll have to hand over to...